Today is a day, as you know, we set one day in a year where we all come together in reverence and prayer. The milad is for the Muslim boys. We have a mass there to celebrate the birth year of Hazrat Maryam, or Mother Mary as we call her. And today's time we started something different also. You know, we have a large number of Hindu Pauliens out here. So we said, why not give them also a chance to show their reverence in prayer. So today is the day of prayer. Because I want all of you to understand, we may think we know everything, but we are very simple Nachis. And we must understand, if you paint yourself, consider yourself as a Nachis in the eyes of God, in the eyes of Allah, then you will find a lot of blessings coming to you. His ne'mate, as we say, will come be showered on you because you are humbling yourself before Him. When you go into sajda, what are you trying to tell God? That I am nothing in front of you, you are everything. I place myself in your hands. And that every religion teaches us that. And every religion tries to teach peace, love and brotherhood. Brotherhood, key word. You see, in the world, we are actually scattered nowadays. We have gone away from humanity. We are not appreciating the human values. That if he is a human, we must respect him. Here is the time for us to take these values in from our own religions. And a milad gives us that when we celebrate the life of Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. And you see his teachings. Prophet Muhammad's teaching is nothing else but peace and brotherhood. It tells you all. So if we believe in Prophet Muhammad and his teachings, and obviously that is a message come to him from Allah, so if we can take those values of the teachings of Prophet Muhammad, we are automatically doing a lot of service to the world. So we must actually inculcate those Islamic values in our lives. Take the meaning of it. You have so many people in their lives around the Prophet who were so important and portrayed the life of Islam. Not dividing people and not saying, I am the best or I am the one, only the right person. You will never find that. True Muslim will never tell you that. By their lives, they will actually show that you are the one, that if you see something good in us, they will follow you automatically. So I like all of you, Paulians. I use this word Paulians because today is the day we may be put in different rooms out there. But each one, we prayed for you, all you boys here. And I'm sure the Hindu boys also prayed for you. Because we are Paulian family. And I keep saying this every time. Because I believe in this. Prayer does not come by words. By bayan or whatever you may say. These are prayers. That's a praise to Allah. But if we believe, then the words will flow. There will be no ending. Dua can go on for hours. If it really comes from inside you. And you'll get so emotional. You'll find tears, everything rolling down your eyes of it. Because that's the time you are actually in the presence of the Lord. In the presence of Allah. And He is the merciful and beneficent. If we keep that, we say, no, Bismillah, in Rahman-e-Rahim, what does that mean? You're trying to place yourself in God's presence. He's the one who can give us His graces, His blessing, make us into something. Pakistan is at the crossroads now. Pakistan needs everyone's help. And most of all, we need everyone's prayers. So here was a nice day today, and I'm sure you heard a lot of lovely naats, because I know when Sir Arif prepares them, they always do a good job. So first of all, I'd like to thank Sir Arif for always taking time and the effort to have this occasion in a way which is very solemn. Just to let you know, they are also planning a milad on the Catholic board level now. That means all the Catholic board schools are going to prepare a milad this year. And they were very impressed, I must say, with Sir Arif and his experience behind it. So I want you to put your hand together for Sir Arif for the effort of it. Because when I met the secretary out there, I know the best person, we have to organize it already in our school and give ideas how we can make it better, was to send Sir Arif for that meeting. And this is what the secretary told me, I'm happy you sent Sir Arif Because he gave us so many ideas how we can make the milad in a way that is more meaningful to everyone. So again, put your hand together for Sahab. But I'm sure Sir Arif also will agree, alone he can't do anything. He has to have the help of all the teachers, all the volunteers, and most of all, you wonderful students. If you don't participate and come forward to present the Naats, then I'm sure this is not possible. Arif akela kuch nahi kar sakta. Your presence says a lot. That you're willing, that means prayer means something to you. You're not coming here to get a certificate. And if you have that feeling inside you, you have automatically become something. But carry that forward in your daily life. That's all I say. That it should not be that you are fighting with one another, catching one another's throats, and I'm calling parents and suspending you all, which is the last thing I like to do, but what to do? So if you feel the presence of Allah in your life and the teachings of Islam in your life, that teaches us peace and brotherhood. And these are all your brothers. We keep saying, all your family, that these are your brothers. They can't be your sisters, can they? So if they are your brothers, then you have to respect them, love them, and see that they are not bullied. Very often I get bigger boys bullying the smaller boys or stealing their break. I don't have, if you, any one of you don't have any money to buy anything for your break, come to me, I will give you. But what I'm saying, don't hurt another boy. By abusing, very often we use galti, galati, sometimes we get angry, we can't control ourselves. These are things that no religion teaches you to hurt another one. And I tell you, love, you hurt someone by abuse or you say something about his mother and father, khada ho jate. Why? Because you hurt him more than anything, because of the respect of the parents. I want to give you that message also. Respect your parents. It's not easy. Sometimes you get so angry. But if they are giving you something, they are giving, teaching you also something. They are giving you responsibility. They trust that you can do it. So never refuse your parents. And like I was telling you yesterday, I don't know how many of you really went and did it, that if you passed any of our rangers, you know, go and shake hands and say thank you. How many of you did that? Okay, if you did it, I'm happy. And did you see any smile on his face? When you went in, was he happy?
Yes, sir.
I know I had to go to a court case, and there was a police fellow sitting there. When I shook him and said, he was stunned. Was he saying, "Pata nahi kya keh rahe?" But then after he was happy, I said, "Today is the day they're celebrating Defence Day. So thank you for all your service. Because they are on the front line protecting us in everything. So we must pray. Remember, they also have families and everything. And they become shaheed, they offer, the bomb blasts are going off, they are on the front line, it's trying to save you. So it's important, we must learn to respect one another. When we give respect, we will earn respect. You can't expect others to respect you if you only keep expecting them to do, and I'm not going to do anything. That's not going to happen. Then you create enmities. And we don't want enmities, and I definitely don't want it in St. Paul's School. Because we are Paulian family, alright? So thank you, Sir Arif, once again, all the teachers for having a nice milad earlier. And we must pick out the better boys from here. I'm sure you attended the meeting because they're going to have a bigger milad thing there on the all Catholic boards. And Sir Arif will guide you on that. Thank you one more.
Thank you, sir. Now I request Hassan.